I have to apologize because the title of this video is somewhat misleading, but only somewhat. Somewhat clickbaity, you know, right? But not completely, right? Suicide Squad 3 may be doomed, I guess, given, you know, that everybody, well, not everybody, but a lot of people seem to have turned on the Suicide Squad, which is kind of sort of Suicide Squad 2, because its box office has done terrible. And I think it's weird because, you know, we're in the middle of like a pandemic. The movie's available like almost like for free on a streaming service at the same time. So I think a lot of people are watching it. They're just not paying to watch it in a theater. But anyhow, for whatever reason, a lot of people are acting like this movie is a huge failure. And we haven't heard anything about a Suicide Squad 3, right? Before The Suicide Squad came out, there were all these articles talking about how Warner Brothers had so much faith in James Gunn, and they still might. Like I said, it's doing well, I think, on streaming. A lot of people are watching it at home. I don't know what's going on inside Warner Brothers, and you don't either. But they haven't said James Gunn's coming back for Suicide Squad 3, right? It's been pretty quiet on that front. So, is Warner Brothers worried? If they are, though, they may have just saved any prospects for Suicide Squad 3 or any DC movie that's going to come out in theaters next year, right? Because they signed a deal with AMC Theaters, and as time goes on, I'm sure it will be with more theaters, to do a 45-day window, right, for 2022. None of that same day, you know, simultaneous digital and theatrical release, which is the reason why Suicide Squad's not making that much money at the box office. They're going to do it where they just put the movie, whatever movie it is, Suicide Squad 3 or whatever, in theaters for 45 days first before moving it to like PVOD or streaming or whatever. So, if they were to make a Suicide Squad 3, they would have more confidence because they'd know the movie would make as much money as it could possibly make because it's not going to be out in theaters and on streaming at the same time, right? Which is one of the things that's killing the Suicide Squad's box office dollars right now. The fact that all these people can just watch it at home without having to go to a theater and pay an extra ticket. And that's how, you know, all Warner Brothers and DC movies are going to be next year. And probably, you know, movies by all studios, I'll bet. The only one that's doing it right now is, I think, Universal, currently this year, doing the 45-day window. And it's worked out great for them. And Disney, I think, is going to do theatrical only later this, for all their other movies later this year. Or many of them, like Shang-Chi and, I think, Eternals, right? But we're going to see how well those do, right? Because even with that, you know, the Delta variant is keeping a lot of people at home. Like Free Guy, which people are acting like is really successful right now, that, like, is theaters only for a certain window, but it only made, like, $26 million or $28 million worldwide, which I guess is good by pandemic standards, but pretty terrible if you think about it. Like, before all this happened, a movie opening with $28 million opening weekend, that wouldn't be called a huge success. If it was like a mainstream movie like Free Guy is. And it's interesting because Free Guy opened with around the same money that The Suicide Squad got, but for some reason people are acting like Free Guy is this huge hit while The Suicide Squad is like a flop. And well, there are reasons for that, but I think really a lot of people are being too hard on The Suicide Squad because, like I said, pandemic and, you know, simultaneous streaming release, right? Free Guy does not have a simultaneous streaming release. That's why it opened the way it did. Imagine how much more money The Suicide Squad would have made if it was a theaters-only exclusive. It probably would have gotten into the $30 or $40 million range. But anyways, if Warner Brothers was concerned about how much money The Suicide Squad brand would make, their 45-day theatrical window next year could make them a bit more, could put them a bit more at ease, right? Because they would know that people would be forced to see it in theaters, and thus it would probably make more money than it would otherwise. But, you know, they may not have faith in the Suicide Squad IP anymore. But we'll see. We'll see what happens with the Suicide Squad again. I know that, besides in the comics, I mean, I know that there is a video game, that Suicide Squad video game that they're making. If that's successful, you know, that could be evidence, a reinvigoration of the brand in Warner Brothers' eyes. Assuming Warner Brothers is unhappy. Like I said, they could be really happy with the Suicide Squad internally. They just aren't saying anything. We'll find out eventually. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please like it on YouTube and subscribe to the channel because I appreciate your viewership, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.